and Breathe Normally is the second Nordic debut feature film directed by a woman that I'm reviewing today, and it is the second of those classifications that I have very good things to say about. Hi there, guys, and welcome to the brand new Reykjavik Review channel. Yes, this is the second channel, but it's going to take the name of the first channel because this one is going to be where I talk about foreign language, series, and movies. So if you're coming over from the other channel, thank you so much for sticking with me through that content that you maybe weren't that interested in. If you're still interested in that content, you can, of course, stay subscribed over there. But remember to subscribe to this channel so that you'll see all the foreign language series, reviews, movies, etc. If you're completely new here, like totally, you've never seen any of this before, what this channel is reviews of foreign language TV shows and movies. Because while a lot of people are talking about the awesome stuff, like, you know, Stranger Things, etc., not many people are talking about the very cool stuff also coming out of Iceland, Denmark, Belgium, France, etc. So that's what I do here. If that sounds interesting to you, stick around and subscribe. And Breathe Normally is the feature debut by Icelandic director Isold Uggadottir, and it is a fantastic little film. And I call it little not to talk down to it, and it's not that it's particularly short or obviously shot on a low budget, though it probably was. It's just that with this film, they've gone for telling a small story well rather than telling a big, complicated story that they don't have the means to tell properly. People say that despite big budget Hollywood action crazy stuff, that we all still want to see nuance in film. But the IMDb score for this film suggests otherwise. It is a much better film than 6.8 out of 10, which is relatively low on IMDb. And if you actually read some of the 1- and 2-star reviews, you'll see the sort of intellect that you'd have in order to feel that this film is actually that bad. One of those reviews, in fact, has clearly misunderstood the goings-on of the film. Like, they've not just missed the point, they've missed what is actually happening in every scene. This is one of the more realistic films I've seen. And I know that not everyone's going to agree with me on that because they're going to think about it in terms of overarching messages and outcomes for certain characters. But I'm talking about in the portrayal of the small things. So the way the mother talks to her son when she's very much down on her luck. My son was that age not very long ago, and I can remember the way I talk to him when things are going really badly. It's very realistic, not just her and her son, but the other main character. So it's all the small things that are realistic and just make for a convincing experience. The small conversations between shop assistants and the main character, the conversations between people who we're not going to see again in the film, and we know that, but they're just so realistic that we want for these characters. We feel for them, we want them to get what they want. Probably the least realistic thing about this film is the amount of characters who belong to some kind of minority. Now, please don't let my saying that turn you off watching this film, because it's not that it's preachy, it's just a little bit on the heavy side in terms of character representation. This film paints a picture of systems which don't care for people, not because people don't care about other people, but because systems are systems. That's just the way they are. So this film is about the lives of two people within those systems. And if that sounds like some lame, clearly written for the sake of academia story that you had to read at school and then write an essay about, then I apologize, because I do this film a disservice to make it sound like that. It's just a very elegantly told story. It's not extravagant, it's not schmaltzy, it's not a tearjerker. It's just good performances, good cinematography, good everything, and just enough intrigue to keep us interested. Now, let me be clear. I am not saying that it's a masterpiece. If you watch my review and then you go into this film expecting a masterpiece, you're going to be disappointed. If you want a masterpiece from Iceland, then watch the first season of Trapped, or listen to Kallio, or Emiliana Torrini, or basically any number of Icelandic musicians. I don't know what it is about Icelanders, but they're just so good at coming up with these stories that are just big enough to allow room on the canvas for a certain kind of mood. Even though this film is very different to the series Trapped, I'd say they're similar in that the story is secondary to the mood. The mood comes first, and this mood can only be evoked through certain kinds of stories, and this story would not survive being told very differently, being told clumsily or extravagantly. It's a very fine balance, and they nail it nicely here. The blend is so delicate. I know this sounds a bit pretentious, but I really feel like they have a different way of doing things up there. So I definitely recommend And Breathe Normally, just as long as you can deal with slow pacing and a small story being told in a small way. As I said, the performances are really good. I really enjoyed this film first and second time around, and I'm very much looking forward to seeing what we get out of director Isold Uggadottir in the future. Guys, I hope you enjoyed this one. If you did, then please consider subscribing. This channel is all about foreign language series and foreign language films. I've got tons and tons of good videos very soon to come. That doesn't make sense, but you get what I mean. For now, thank you for watching this one, and I'll see you next time. It's not schmaltzy, it's not a tearjoker. A tearjoker.